Namaskaram girls.
Now we are going to move to the illustration number 1, which is given in your book 103. Page number 103. Now we are going to start the purchases book. So I will explain the sum first. Illustration 1. Record the following transaction in the purchases book of Shanti Furniture Mart. See, they have given the date. You know the format, isn't it? So you are going to write the format first. For starting the purchases book, before writing the illustration, start to write the format, and then you can start to copy down the sums. Date, you can write the format, particulars, invoice number, LF, details and total. While we are writing the details, if there is any, we have to multiply 50 fans at 100 rupees means that two or more items, if he purchased, that item should be come here in a column, and the grand total alone not to take to the outer column, so that we are given this two division. So details column should be in the inner column, and the total column, aggregate total will be come, and we have to take down and write in the total column. So let us move on to the sum. March 1st, purchased from Hogan Furniture Mart, rupees Madurai, 20 chairs at 450 each, isn't it? So first you can go through the sum, which alone want to bring it to the purchases book. Only credit purchase. We should not bring the cash purchase. Do you know already? Isn't it? So March, 20 chairs at 450 each and 2 tables at 1000 each. For that, they have given the discount, trade discount at 10%. That also we have to reduce from the total amount. Then March 6th, purchased for cash rupees Welcome Furniture Vellore to Almira. For cash, you can understand, underline the word cash. So that entry, that we should not take, March 6th transaction, we should not take into the account, because it is a cash transaction. So we should not take it to the purchases book, because purchases book for what we are maintaining, only credit purchase alone we are going to maintain. Then March 7, bought from Ramesh & Co. Raipeta, 2 stools at 500 each, 10 rolling chairs at 200 each, delivery charges and cartage. Delivery charges means the delivery charges are direct expenses, so that will be charged from the purchaser. Because why they are, we are doing like this, they are added to the amount payable, so that we have to add along with the purchaser that want to include, because it is a credit purchase. Credit purchase means in the journal entry itself I have told you, they have given the name of the purchaser, so that we can easily identify the credit purchase. Here they have given the, apparently they have given purchase for cash, means we have to omit the transaction. Then March 20, purchased 2 computer for office use from Anandan & Co. Adayar on credit. That transaction will be included, rupees 15,550 each. That transaction will be included, you can think and tell. No, because purchased 2 computer for office use, computer purchase, that is asset. So asset purchase will be entered into the journal proper, so that it should not be bring into the purchases book. While reading the sum itself, while go throughing the sum, you can recollect all the points. Then March 21st, purchased from Kamala & Co. Karaikal, 10 chairs at 750 each, 15 steel cabinet at 1500 each, packing and delivery charges rupees 250 and less trade discount. Here they are giving the, we want to add the delivery charges and we have to reduce the trade discount. So the explanation of the sum was over. Now let us move on getting to the solution. First one, Mohan Furniture Mart. So while reading the sum, you can come to the conclusion which one should be added. 2017 March 1, Mohan Furniture Mart. is all the column 1 to fully 1 right comes. Yes, we are right. 20 chairs at 20 chairs at 450 each. Then next one, what you can total and tell me? 20 into 450, 9000. Write it in the inner column. Invoice number, everything. Because of the format we are writing. Now we during the practicals, practically when we are going to the working environment, we will write all the column. Now we are studying, so that we must know. So that for that purpose we are writing this column. Then next one, two tables at 1000 rupees also you should mention each. How much rupees? 2000. Then write the total amount in the outer column, because we should not write the total amount. Before writing, you should check whether the trade discount or delivery charges is there or not. So, delivery, the trade discount is there, isn't it? So, less trade discount of 10%. So, 11,000, totally 11,000 is coming. Less trade discount. Less trade discount. Why they are giving the trade discount? Because it is a 10%. 10%, 1000 rupees, isn't it? So net amount what? 10,000 rupees. 1,100. 11,000, 1,100 rupees. 9,900. So that amount alone want to keep bring it to the outer column. Then March 7. Without leaving a line, after writing this one particular transaction, you can leave. Then Ramesh Ankur Ayapeta. What is the amount? Two stools at rupees 500 each. 1000 rupees, isn't it? So 1000, you can write it here. Then 10 rolling chairs. 10 rolling chairs at 200 each. How many rupees? 2000 rupees. Is there any trade discount or delivery charges they have given? Yes, there is a delivery charges. Delivery charges, they have given the charges 150 rupees. That should be included. Delivery charges should be, you can see, delivery charges and the cartage, these are all direct charges, direct expenses. So these chargeable from the purchaser. So they are added to the amount payable. So those who are purchasing the goods, they want to pay the delivery charges and they have to get the delivery of the product. So that should be added. How many rupees? 3000 rupees plus add delivery charges. $150. Then move on to next one. March 21st. Ramesh Ankur, isn't it? Kamal Ankur. Kamal Ankur. Karikar. What we have purchased? So whatever you are writing, this sentence you are not going to write anything else. Which line you are going to write? The next amount, how many description you are writing now? In that description line alone, we are going to write the amount. So 10 chairs at 750 each. Then how much rupees is coming? 7500. Write it in the inner column. 15 steel chairs. Steel chairs. At how many rupees? 1500 each. Then 22,500, isn't it? So here we have to reduce the discount 10%, and then we have to add the packing and delivery charges. So total, add the total amount is 30,000 rupees, isn't it? So 30,000 rupees less trade discount, how many rupees? Less trade discount. For short, I will write it TD. You should not write, you have to write fully. So trade discount at 10%, 3,000 rupees. So what will be the amount? 27,000. Then want to add the delivery charges. Add packing and delivery charges. What is the amount? It is a very easy sum, girls. Delivery and packing charges. Whatever it may be, both are correct. Packing charges. What is the amount? 150, isn't it? So what is the total amount? 27,000. Sorry, 250 rupees. So 250 rupees. So what is the total? 27,250. So what is the total purchase? You can add and tell. 27,000. Total amount is 40,300. Isn't it? So 40,300. That is the total purchases. So purchases account debit. We are going to debit the purchases. See here, for your identification, I will tell you one thing. Journal entry, how we will write the for purchases, credit purchase. What you can do, because of your verification, I am telling. See, purchases account data. What is the journal entry for credit purchase? Purchases account data to party account, isn't it? So, who? Any Mala, Sita, Selva, whatever it may be. So, like the same way, purchases account should be debited. Have you understood? So, purchases account data to party. So that here, why we are writing debit? Purchases account should be debited in the ledger. While posting the ledger, how we are going to post in the ledger? What we will do in the purchases account? Journal entry will debit, isn't it? So that we are writing this purchases account data. How we will write the ledger account? Ledger posting, let us see in the next sum. Here you can see purchases account data 40,000 rupees. So in the ledger, what we will do in the purchases account? Party account should be here in the journal entry, it is credited. So in the ledger, we will debit, isn't it? So how to post in the ledger account? We should not balance the ledger. Everything we are going to see in the next illustration.